It must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side. It must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side.
Every action has its equal opposite reaction. Thanks to Hamilton, our cabinet's fractured into factions. Try not to crack under the stress, we're breaking down like fractions. We smack each other in the press and we don't print retractions. I get no satisfaction witnessing his fits of passion. The way he primps and preens and dresses like the pits of fashion. Our poorest citizens, our farmers, live ration to ration as Wall Street robs them blind in search of chips to cash in. This prick is asking for someone to bring him to task. Somebody give me some dirt on his vacuous mask so we can at last unmask him. I'll pull the trigger on him, someone load the gun and cock it. While we were all watching, he got Washington in his pocket.
It must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side. It must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side. Look back at the Bill of Rights,
which I wrote,
the ink hasn't dried. It must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side.
So he's doubled the size of the government. Wasn't the trouble with much of our previous government size?
Look in his eyes,
see how he lies.
Follow the scent of his enterprise.
Centralizing national credit and making American credit competitive.
If we don't stop it, we aid and abet it.
I have to resign.
Somebody has to stand up for the South.
But somebody has to stand up to his mouth.
If there's a fire you're trying to douse, you can't put it out from inside the house. I'm in the cabinet, I am complicit in watching him grabbing at power and kissing him. Washington isn't gonna listen to disciplined dissidents. This is the difference, this kid is out.
Oh, this immigrant isn't somebody we chose. Oh, this immigrant's keeping us all on our toes. Oh, let's show these federalists who they're up against. Oh, Southern motherfucking Democratic Republicans. Oh, now follow the money and see where it goes. Oh, because every second the treasury grows. Oh, if we follow the money and see where it leads, get in the weeds for the seeds of Hamilton's misdeeds. It must be nice, it must be nice.
Follow the money and see where it goes.
It must be nice, it must be nice.
The emperor has no clothes.
We won't be invisible. We won't be denied. Still, it must be nice, it must be nice to have Washington on your side.
Mr. President, you asked to see me. I know you're busy. What do you need, sir? Sir,
I want to give you a word of warning.
Sir, I don't know what you heard, but whatever it is, Jefferson started it.
Thomas Jefferson resigned this morning.
You're kidding.
I need a favor.
Whatever you say, sir, Jefferson will pay for this behavior.
Shh, talk less.
I'll use the press. I'll write under a pseudonym. You'll see what I can do to him.
I need you to draft an address.
Yes, he resigned. You can finally speak your mind.
No. He's stepping down so he can run for president.
Ha! Good luck defeating you, sir.
I'm stepping down, I'm not running for president.
I'm sorry, what?
One last time. Relax, have a drink with me. One last time. Let's take a break tonight, and then we'll teach him how to say goodbye. To say goodbye, you and I.
To talk about neutrality.
Sir,
with Britain and France on the verge of war, is this the best
time? I want
time?
To warn against partisan fighting.
What?
Pick up a pen, start writing. I want to talk about what I have learned, the hard-won wisdom I have earned.
As far as the people are concerned, you have to serve. You could continue to serve.
No. One last time, the people will hear from me. One last time. And if we get this right, we're gonna teach them how to say goodbye. You and I.
Mr. President, we will say you're weak.
No. to move them along.
Why do you have to say goodbye?
If I say goodbye, the nation learns to move on. It outlives me when I'm gone. Like the scripture says, everyone shall sit under their own vine and fig tree, and no one shall make them afraid. They'll be safe in the nation we've made. I want to sit under my own vine and fig tree, a moment alone in the shade, at home in this nation we've made. One last time.
One last time. Though, in reviewing the incidents of my administration, I am unconscious of intentional error, I am nevertheless too sensible of my defects not to think it probable that I may have committed many errors. I shall also carry with me the hope that my country will view them with indulgence, and that after 45 years of my life dedicated to its service with an upright zeal, the faults of incompetent abilities will be consigned to oblivion, as I myself will soon be to the mansions of rest. I anticipate with pleasing expectation that retreat in which I promise myself to realize the sweet enjoyment of partaking in the midst of my fellow citizens, the benign influence of the good laws of a free government, the ever favorite object of my heart, and a happy reward, as I trust, our mutual cares, labors, and dangers. One last time.
George Washington's going home.
You teach him how to say goodbye.
George Washington's going home.
You and I.